Welcome back once again on our YouTube channel. So as we have completed chapter number 8 in the physical classes, that is economic reforms. So now we are going to start our new chapter, that is 9, national income. So the word income you all have heard at your home. Okay, so you are very familiar with the income word. Now the national income, it means that nation's income. Okay, so we'll see the introduction part first, what this chapter is going to say us, right? So this national income, it includes the macroeconomic. So now you will say, what is macroeconomic? So it's a branch of the economy, okay, which includes the behavior and the structure of the economy. So in that, we need to see the changes, in which sectors changes comes, or where the changes comes, and for where it is necessary to do the changes. So changes can be in the form of the unemployment, growth rate, gross domestic product, and the inflation. So we see the changes in these every now and then. Okay, so this includes the macroeconomic. Now this is just I'm explaining what is the macroeconomic. In this we are not going to study deep for the macroeconomics, as it's going to be coming to the 12th. Okay, so afterwards now we'll discuss about the national income. So national income is the main concept. Okay, it shows the balance sheet of a country. Now you will say how balance sheet of a country. See, if the company at the end of the year, we are making the final accounts, right? Always company makes the final accounts. So they prepare the balance sheet. So according to the balance sheet, they come to know the performance of the company. So in the same way, for the country, when we see the balance sheet of a country, of any nation, so we'll come to know the performance of any country. Okay, so it can be said that balance sheet, nation's balance sheet, when we observe, we come to know about the performance of the economic of that particular country. Then if any country shows the good balance sheet, like in the balance sheet performance is good, so we can say that country is healthy in terms of economic. Healthy means not in the like in the term of ke wo bimar hai ya kya, not like that. Healthy means that country is good and the wealthy. In that country there is a placement of unemployment, growth rate is good. Okay, so due to that effect is not coming in any of the sectors. So they get a good profit. It means that that particular country's economic health condition is good. Okay, so if the national income of any economic increases slowly, or if it is low and increases slowly, so it shows that the unhealthiness of a national income. Kisi bhi nation ki economic jo hoti hai wo low hai and it's increasing slowly, so it shows the unhealthiness of an economy. Okay, so in short, national income is the criteria. National income is the criteria to decide the income of country. Okay, if national income is good, so obviously economically that country will be healthy or good. Okay, now we'll see the meaning. So the market value of product or the goods, you can say, and services produced by using the national wealth with capital and labor. So the market value of the final goods, the finished goods which we are presenting into the market, so that goods and service is produced by using the nation's wealth and the capital and the labor. Jo country ki wealth hai, country ka paisa hai, country ka jo investors hote hai wo, and the labor which we are using, okay, that is known as the, we are using of the one, means in a year, during a whole year, that is known as national income. Okay, so another concepts are also there in this chapter, the important concepts that are GNP, NNP, GDP and NDP of the national income. This is omitted from the syllabus for this year, but we are not going to omit this because this is also an important concept. Then only you will come to know, this is the basic, right? So we are going to do this. So after that, we'll see the national income definition according to three famous economists. They have definition of national income in their view of point. Okay, but the meaning is same. They want to teach us, they want to make the clear the concept of national income, but they have a different point of view. So we'll see what points are they have. So these three are the economists. They have given the definitions in their point of view. So first we'll see the general meaning. So the general meaning of the national income is that the monetary value of a production. Okay, so from where we get the production, what are the sectors from that we'll get the goods and the service, means we get the product and the service. So the three sectors are, first is agriculture, second is industrial, and the third is service sector. So from these three sectors we get the production. What we get? We get the production. Okay. So the value of that product and service is known as the national income. So means in a whole year or during a year, the products which we are manufacturing or the product hum banate hai, that is known as the, that value for the products and the service is known as the national income. That this is the general meaning. Okay. So we can say that the national income of our country is 128 lakh crores. Okay, because this is the income of the whole country, not for the one company or the one family. Okay, this is the income of the whole country. So we can say that rupees 128 lakh crores is the income of a country. Okay, so this is the income. So this income comes from these three sectors. Okay, from these three sectors only this income comes. So this income is known as the national income. This was the general meaning. Now we'll talk about the Professor Alfred Marshall. Now Professor Alfred Marshall, his definition is totally based on the production. How? Means the net production of any product, goods or the services by using wealth of the country, means capital and labor. Okay, jo bhi cheez hum use kar rahe hain, like capital and the labor which we are using, aur usse jo product ban raha hai, by using these things, okay, जो product बनता है, जो product की value होती है, that value of the product is known as the national income according to him. For example, if I'm suppose I'm a cloth merchant and I want to manufacture the 10,000 jeans, okay, 10,000 jeans I have manufactured. So price, I'm only going to decide what is the price. So I've kept, it's just example, 100 rupees for that. Okay, so this is the value this is the value of the product. So that is known as the national income, because if 10,000 jeans I have manufactured, so obviously I'm going to sell into the market, that I need, that I have to sell into the market, then only I'll get the money. So I have decided the product's price. Okay, so this will be income for me. So that's why it says that the production based definition. Clear? Now Irving Fisher definition is based on the consumption. Consumption means the consumers which buy the things from the market. Okay, they are doing expense, means consumers are doing expenses for the products. So consumption. So as the consumers, they are going to purchase the products. Okay, or they can be having a services. So that money they are going to pay in exchange of that product and the services. So that money will be the national income of a country. Understood? Here manufacturer is manufacturing the product, so he is deciding the price of the product, right? For that is the income, because he is going to sell into the market and consumers are going to purchase that thing. So in term of the product and the services, they are going that productions means that people, they will get the money. Okay, so that money is known as the income money, means which is used on the consumption. By using the money they give, that is known as the consumption based. Okay, now the third person is AC Pigou. This is totally based on the money. Now how? As we have sale into the market, that suppose 10,000 jeans have sale into the market, against of that I'm going to have the payment. Right, the goods which to mere ye all 10,000 jeans I'm going to sell into the market because I'm the manufacturer. Aisa to nahi hai ki like 10,000 se 20,000 ke jeans main usme dal dungi. No, because I have a production of only 10,000. Okay, so all 10,000 jeans I'm going to sell into the market, so against that I'll get the payment. And if I have given that 10,000 to any of the firm or any of the companies or any of the shop, if I have given to them, so they are going to give me in the exchange of that, they are going to give me the money. So koi bhi goods agar transfer kahin pe jate hain, so in term of that we get the money. Koi bhi goods or the services we are doing, okay, so that we get the money. In the other words, we can say that the income, total income of the society, okay, along with the foreign income too, which we calculate in the terms of the money. Okay, so these three economists were there. They have different point of view of their national income, but at the end definitions are different, but they want to clear the concept of the national income. Okay, so this was the meanings and the definitions. Now we'll see the national product and the national income. So national product and national income, almost we have the concept that these both things are the similar. Okay, national product is also similar, national income is also similar. No, it's not. As I said, national income, national product, both concepts are different. So national income means the sum of the total income, okay, the sum of the total income obtained from the contribution of four factors. Means total national income we get from the contribution of the four factors. Which four factors are that? We get the income, and that we can say the national income. The four factors are rent plus wages plus interest plus rent, wages, interest, and the main is profit. Okay, so the income obtained from the contribution of these four factors by production of a company. So this, the rent is a, means if a company is on the rent, so they are going to pay the rent, that is the income. Wages means the labor which we give to the employment. Interest on the capital, and this is the profit of the product. Okay, if we merge it, so we will get the national income. So now the national product. Now The sum of the total production value of final products and services obtained by the various factors. अब the value of the final goods and services, okay, obtained by the different sectors or from the different factors of the production in various sectors. We have a three sectors, okay, and from that three sectors we get the final product and services, which I explained you in the national income definition. And the three sectors are agriculture, services and industrial sector. From these three sectors we get the value of the product and services. So that value of the product and services is called the national product. Okay, now suppose if state does not have the intervention means the tax. If state does not have the tax on the product, okay, or if state does not do any foreign exchange, means import and export. So in that case, national income and the national product will have the stability. वो क्या हो जाएगा? Stable हो जाएगा, okay? If we won't have the tax on any of the goods, if we don't do the import and export, okay? So they both will be having a stability. Clear? Due to the taxes on the product, national product, okay? So rate will be high for the of that product because we are including the tax. So due to that, price of product increase, okay, price of the product will increase, but expenditure of that product will not increase, okay. Price, production expenditure. Suppose as I have given the explanation of the example of the 10,000 jeans. If we are exporting to the any country, so tax will added in that. Okay, but expense will not increase of ours. Will increase the price of the product compared to the production expense. Of 10,000 jeans, which mera expense hua hoga, that will not increase. Okay, that will remain the same. But compared to that, price of the product will increase because we are adding the tax in it. Okay, and besides that, due to the subsidies and the discounts or the subsidies given by the government, okay, so in comparison for that, national product will be having the lower price. That national product will be having the lower price. अगर गवर्नमेंट सब्सिडी देगी, डिस्काउंट देगी, सो ऑब्वियसली प्राइस ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट विल बी लो. ओके, सो दिस वॉज द नेशनल इनकम एंड द नेशनल प्रोडक्ट. एंड वॉट विल बी द लाइक इफ वॉट वी आर गोइंग टू इंक्रीज, सो वॉट विल हैपन एंड वॉट वी आर गोइंग टू डिक्रीज, सो वॉट विल हैपन आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू वेदर वी आर इफ टैक्स विल बी इंक्लूडेड, सो वॉट कैन बी इंक्रीज और द टैक्स विल बी means discount can be given, so what can be happen with the national income, means the national income will be high, but product of that particular means product price will be decreased if subsidy given by the or the discount given by the government. Okay, I hope you all have understand the introduction part properly, then the concept of national income and the definition given by the three economists, okay, in a different point of view. And then we have did the national income and the national product. They both are the different in a manner. Okay, so I hope you have understand all these concepts properly. If you have any doubt, we'll clear that thing into the live sessions. Till that time, good day and take care of yourself. Thank you.